West. They called their music Northern Soul.
There's always some fond memories connected with the Northern Soul Motown sound. And everybody that was a part of it tries to do anything and everything that they can to keep it alive. And it keeps surviving. And that just goes to show you the legacy of the music.
Now, new fans are discovering the scene. And many of the old-timers are back, looking a little older perhaps, but just as enthusiastic.
It's the music, we love records.
The people you meet and so friendly.
The atmosphere, the people, the music, just everything. You cannot beat it anywhere else.
If the music's inside you, it grabs you and there's nothing you can do about it. You just got to keep going and it drags you along.
The soul sound is back with a vengeance, and it's happening right here in the Midlands. It's early morning on the set of Function at the Junction. It's a new feature film being shot in Nottingham, all about the soul scene of the 70s.
You've got the old clubbers like me who like still like the music, and then you've got like a new generation who dig the music too. So it is purely because it's beautiful music.
Its writer and its director are both big soul fans, and they think it's time everyone else learned to share their passion.
It's a classic example of British youth picking up on a music that America had largely rejected. America didn't really want this music, and British youth taking it and making it their own and creating their own scene out of it.
Look out, babe. The scene is really kicking back in now in England itself. And it's sort of rejuvenating the real music, as it were, and it's undercutting the club scene, and it's still got the rave appeal and the sort of high energy appeal, but real voice, real singers, real songs, you know. And it strikes me that it's becoming a la mode. It's going to set a trend, I think, if it catches on.
Back in the 70s, the Midlands soul scene was thriving. Every Friday and Saturday night, thousands of young people travel to events across the country. Sometimes they'd travel hundreds of miles just to get to a soul night at one of the famous clubs in Nottingham, Derby or Stoke-on-Trent. Stoke's most famous club was the Golden Torch. A close second was the Magic Roundabout. One of the original DJs at the Magic Roundabout was Colin Curtis. He took me to what's left of the club, this derelict building in the Potteries town of Burslem.
This place just doesn't feel like a happening club, Colin. What was it like back then?
Back then it was almost exactly like you see it now, only very dark. We would come along the corridor here and eventually end up here. But the music, the noise, the lights would come through these ornate glass windows that are still here, and they've got that inside as well. That was very, very much a part of this particular scene. There were nights that were tucked away because your mainstream club wouldn't really be interested in promoting this, so they'd be tucked away in places like this. And this was probably one of the original all-nighters, where people would actually stay here till 7 and 8 in the morning with a breakfast thrown in.
But the centre of the Stoke scene was the Golden Torch, here in Tunstall.
You would work your way along the queue here, and then as you turned into the street here, The music would hit you.
There's nothing left of the Torch these days. It's just a car park. But Colin Curtis remembers when this part of Stoke-on-Trent was alive to the sounds of soul.
The Torch epitomised everything, and it was one of the original all-nighters that had mass success and mass coverage through the press, and also through people travelling from all over the UK.
There was a breakdown at Trent Bridge, the all-dayers at the Pally in Nottingham, there was all-dayers at Derby, at Tiffany's, and I used to love not only the music, but how friendly people were. There was no hostility or attitude. Everybody was there for one reason, the love of the music.
You can get thousands of people together. I mean, thousands of people together, and they are dancing within close proximity of each other, and there is never, ever any bother. There's never, ever any harsh words between people. They are purely and simply there for the music and to enjoy themselves. I mean, the times have changed, yes. There used to be a time when young women could sleep on the floor at the venues and they could put their purses down without fear of anyone touching them. You know, yes, times have changed in retrospect of that, but the music is still as strong and the people's dedication is still as strong.
But what was the Northern Soul sound? Where did those tunes come from? The tunes that defined a generation. Northern Soul was based on records produced by the Motown label in Detroit. These were the Big Stars, the Supremes, the Miracles, and the Temptations. But Northern Soul is about their stablemates, singers who never made the Motown TV specials.
It's raw soul. I think the beauty of it is it's made by people who mainly weren't stars. They might have had one crack at making a record and then go back to being a waitress or working in a gas station and not realising that this music was massive in Britain 10 years later.
Years on from the original Motown sound, a new generation is discovering the music and dancing just like they did at the height of Northern Soul. Hinckley may be a long way from Detroit, but the passion for the music is just as strong.
Northern Soul is black American music that very often sounds Motown-esque. It's got the Motown sound, but it's not quite Motown. It's not good enough to be Motown in terms of production quality, but it's got the beat, it's got the vocal harmonies. Very often it's very badly produced in some cases, but it's got heart and soul. It's a dance. It is the dance music of the 60s, 70s.
And now many of the original soul boys are back on the scene. John Heaney was there when it all started. Now he's chauffeur to the mayor of Derby, and he's still a Northern Soul fanatic. It's the soundtrack to his day.
Everybody else was into like Bay City Rollers and David Bowie and things like that, and you wanted to be somewhat different. And I used to have a scooter. I used to be into the scooter scene as well, and that Motown, mod music, soul music, it all intertwined. What you're doing after 30 years, still liking the same music. I'm like thousands of other people who are in the late 40s, are into this kind of music. To me, it's the sound, it's the music, you know, the black 60s American music. That's what I want to hear.
And the Wyking Social Club in Hinckley is the kind of place where John comes to dance when his day's work is over.
Okay, so it's not Wigan Casino, but Northern fans have been looking forward to this night. It's Hinckley Soul Club's 9th anniversary, and the dancers are out in force. And what about the steps we're going to see in here tonight then, John?
Well, hopefully I'll teach you a few basic steps so you'll get on the dance floor and practice them out, and maybe you'll get hooked. And,
let's see then, shall we?
Yeah, come on then, we'll go in.
Fans have travelled from across the Midlands to hear those big tunes one more time. Here you go, Eddie.
It's not glamorous, it's not sophisticated, but they're having fun.
It's like an adrenaline junkie. Once you get past that certain point, you're just lost in the music. And it takes you over and you get so engrossed. You've been waiting to go to places like this during the week. And once that music, you get the right tempo and the right beat, and you're having a good night, you just get carried away with it.
Many of the Northern Soul DJs have been there right from the start.